Welcome, I'm Steve. Today we're going to be talking about spark plugs and spark plug wires on the 2015 Softail. So stay tuned for that. Welcome to Slickbaggers YouTube channel. I'm Steve, and we are going to be doing another install on the 2015 Softail back here. If you've watched our channel before, maybe you're new to the channel, but in the past we've done strictly mainly touring model videos, and now we've got the 15 Softail that we're going to be doing all the way from stock all the way up to a Cholo style build. So maybe if you're new, you can check out the previous videos and stuff that we've already done to the Softail. Now, in the past, we shot videos on the 15 Road Glide and the 14 Street Glide over there from bone stock all the way up to where they are now. Now, when we did all the videos and we built those bikes, I skipped the spark plug wires. I went into Harley-Davidson and I picked up a set of their Screamin' Eagle fat plug wires. I came home, I popped the old wires off and put the new ones on and thought, well, that's not even worth shooting a video on. It's literally a 2-minute install. Just to kind of give you guys some information, just another thing that you can check and do at home. You don't need to pay Harley to do it. This is something you can do very easily at home, and it only takes a few minutes. The very first thing I want to tell you to do is get a service manual for your motorcycle. You don't have to go out and buy a $350 service manual book. They're readily available online. All you have to do is just Google the year and model of your motorcycle and put Harley service manual PDF at the end of it, and I guarantee you, you're going to find a downloadable PDF version of your service manual. Because in today's video, we're doing a 2015 Softail, and these specs may not apply to your motorcycle, but everything else I talk about in this video will apply to your motorcycle. Now, Harley-Davidson suggests we inspect these spark plugs and the spark plug wires every 5,000 miles, and we actually change the spark plugs at 10,000 miles. Now, how many of you out there change your spark plugs at 10,000 miles? I certainly didn't, even though I know that and I do this for a living and it's literally a 10-minute job, I haven't changed my spark plugs. So we just purchased this motorcycle used and we have no idea what those spark plugs look like in there. So today we're gonna be pulling them out, inspecting them, but we are gonna be replacing the stock spark plug wires with the Screamin' Eagle fat plug kit. Now, generally you wouldn't have to change your spark plug wires. You do wanna inspect them. You wanna look for cracks or burns or rub marks or anything like up in here where this wire runs across the top of the horn that can rub. There's different model motorcycles out there and you have different wires that run across stuff, and you wanna inspect those areas to make sure that they're not actually rubbing into the wire. So if you're having hard start issues, rough idle, or poor acceleration, that's a great place to start. Look at your spark plug wires. A, make sure they're connected securely on the motorcycle. If they are, go ahead and pop them off, inspect the spark plug wires to make sure that they're not burnt or rubbed all the way through the wire. So outside of that, you wouldn't generally need to change your spark plug wires. So why in the world would I go spend 30 bucks on two new wires that are just fat wires? These spark plug wires, actually called fat spark plug wires, and that's P-H-A-T, that's pretty clever, Harley, but these fat plug wires from Harley actually are fatter, they're thicker. So that provides more protection against radio and electronic frequencies. So on the twin cam and the Milwaukee Ace, they have what's called an ion sensor. It's actually the ion sensor knock retard system. So what that does is allow the engine to adjust to get rid of spark knock. Spark knock can be caused by a lot of things like crappy fuel, too much heat. There's a lot of variations out there that can cause spark knock. Spark knock is basically when your plug is just firing before it's supposed to. So the ion sensor detects that, it adjusts the engine, and hopefully gets rid of that spark knock. So what's the point of changing to a fat spark plug wire?
It'll make you go faster.
Nope, absolutely not. You're not gonna gain any horsepower from changing to a fat spark plug wire. When you cut these things off and compare them to the inside of the stock spark plug wire, it's exactly the same. The only difference is you have a lot more meat on the outside of that wire. So generally it just makes them last longer, especially if you have rubbing issues. When I first purchased these, I'll be honest with you, I bought them because they look cool. You can get them in several different flavors from Harley-Davidson. Orange with black lettering like we did on the Street Glide, black with orange lettering like we did on the Road Glide, and we got another set of orange with black lettering here, and I think they have some red ones too. I think black with red lettering or red with black lettering as well. So now that we talked a little bit about your spark plugs and the reasons why I switched to the fat plug wires, let's get the camera over here and let's pull these out and take a look at them. So there's a couple of very basic tools that you are going to need to get this done and actually do it correctly. We are going to need a ratchet, of course, and you're going to need a spark plug socket. It's very important that you use a spark plug socket. there's a piece of rubber down in there that protects the porcelain on those spark plugs when you're taking them out and putting them in. If you can get your hands on one of these little tools right here, this is going to save you a lot of time and actually prevent you from damaging your spark plug wires. You can pick up a pack of these at Harbor Freight for about $6, and all they are like dash tools. They're little plastic pry tools. They're kind of used for pulling apart door panels, dash panels, stuff like that, not damaging plastic. This one with the 45 on it like this makes it super easy to pop spark plug wires off without grabbing the spark plug wires up here with pliers. The Milwaukee 8s especially are kind of a pain in the butt to get to those top ones up there, and you don't want to be reaching in there with needle nose and squeezing in and popping them off. Get you a little pry tool like this and it'll pop them right off. When you go to put your plugs back in, you're going to want to put some anti-seize back on the threads of that spark plug. Just makes them super easy to get out next time. Before you put your spark plug wires back on, get yourself some dielectric grease. You can pick this stuff up at your local parts store, your auto parts store. You can get tubes of it on Amazon. We just have little packs of it left over from other jobs. And to get your spark plugs back in correctly, you're going to need a torque wrench. First thing we're going to do is pull the plug off the coil. We're going to take our little pry tool. We're going to put it under the plug. We're going to pop that right off. Now you can inspect the plug wire from here, just making sure that there's no cracks, obvious dry rotting, rubbing where you've rubbed through to the internal wire and that's actually starting to ground out somewhere. We're going to get our bottom one and watch the fins on your engine when you're taking this off, because these little fins can get pretty sharp when you're pulling and popping spark plug wires, kind of cut the back of your hand. We're going to pull this one off. So right above the horn here on the horn bracket, you've got two little zip tie, little Christmas tree pop-end pins. If you get the stock spark plug wires on there, those are gonna be on there. So you're gonna take your little pry tool again and get under that and pop those up and out just like that. We're gonna pull that spark plug wire out. Now we pop those out because you can pop them right back in. If you're just inspecting this wire to make sure it's okay, then you can just pop those right back in the holes. Now from here, we're gonna take our 5/8 spark plug socket. We're gonna break these loose. So get this up in camera. This area right here is going to have a little bit more buildup on it on carbureted bikes than you would see on fuel-injected bikes, but that's not what we're looking for. We're looking at the porcelain around the electrode in the middle. That tan color that you see there, that's the color you're going to be looking for. If you're kind of a tannish color right in there and it's not glassy looking, then you're running a proper fuel-air mixture. If this is a lot lighter or white color, you're going to be running a little lean. Darker, you're going to be running a little bit too rich. So the next thing we're going to check is the gap, and this is where you need to look at your service manual to see what your spark plugs needs. The 15 Softail back here calls for 0.038 to 0.043, but we're going to take our spark plug, we're going to put it on the thinner end, we're going to spin it up to just about where it stops and to make sure it's not caught on there. So you can actually put it up there, take it off, you can actually put it up there in place, take it off, put it back in. We're at exactly 0.038. Now it's very important that if you're putting in new spark plugs that you check the gap as well. Just because you went to say Harley Davidson and bought spark plugs for your 2015 Softail and they bring them out doesn't mean that they're gapped correctly. You need to check the gap on your new spark plugs before you put them in. Hey, I hope you're enjoying the free video. I just wanted to take a real quick second to let you know how much I appreciate the hell out of every one of you. If you're liking what you see on the channel and you want to see more, it tremendously helps our channel if you just click that like button, hit the subscribe button, and tell your friends about us. You can also find Sick Baggers on other social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and even now we have a TikTok, so make sure to look us up over there. Every video that we put out is absolutely free all of the time. We don't have any secret squirrel websites where you have to go and pay us Patreon and all that stuff to see certain videos, and every time we do a video out here, it is absolutely free to you. Check us out everywhere and tell your friends about us. I'm gonna let you get back to the video. So from here, we're gonna put a tad of anti-seize on the threads. Very important not to get anti-seize up here on the top where this sparks. You only want it on the thread. So be careful when you're spinning this stuff around. Always hand start your spark plugs. Don't start your spark plugs with a ratchet. Don't put it on a power tool. Hand start them so you make sure that you don't cross thread. And if you can, just go ahead and run them in by hand until they stop. It's a lot quicker than getting a ratchet up there. Once again, using our spark plug socket, we're going to torque this down, and our motorcycle calls for 12 to 18 foot-pounds. This again. Now from here, you're going to take your dielectric grease. You're going to dab a little. Speaking of dielectric grease, I just opened up the box of spark plug wires, and Harley was cool enough to send us some dielectric grease. So if you don't have any, there you go. When you buy the fat plug wires, you get some. But since we already had some, we've got it on there. So we'll just throw this up in the top of the toolbox and use it on another project like we did that pack. So before you install these, just give them a quick glance over just to make sure. Just because they're brand new doesn't mean they're perfect. We're going to install our rear one. Our old one had the little zip tie plugs that went in here, and we obviously can't reuse those. Those are a one-time deal. So in order to keep this spark plug wire up here where it needs to go and not hanging down here or wherever and rubbing on stuff and eating a hole through my brand new spark plug wire, I am going to just use a black zip tie for now. But for now, I'm going to show you guys a cool little thing I learned a long time ago. Instead of running a zip tie over here and just having this big honking wire hanging over the side of this bracket, what I'm going to do is take my zip tie and bend it in half. Get a little good point on it, and I'm going to poke it up through that hole. I'm going to take this spark plug wire, I'm going to run it through that and pull that down. I'm going to put this back in place, but hopefully you guys can see this. I took the zip tie, bent it in half, and poked the bent half through the hole. I'm going to position this spark plug wire where I want it, you know, visibly, you know, so you can see the screaming eagle on there that we paid extra money for. So we're going to turn that. Now you're going to take this and go ahead and put it through just like a normal zip tie. And this can kind of be hard to get to or hard to see what I'm doing, but I'm going to pull this tight. You have to take that bend back out of it. I'm going to keep pulling it and wrenching it down. And the female side right here of the zip tie is actually going to hold it because it's bigger than the hole that we poked it through. So that gives you a nice clean install. And you can still get in here with your side cutters and cut that zip tie off and push it down. Now we have kind of a little holder there just like that instead of having a big zip tie going around the edge. So that's it right there. That's a nice, easy install of the 10 millimeter fat wires from Harley-Davidson. You can do the black with orange lettering. I think the orange with black lettering and the red with black lettering, or the black with red letterings. So that's it. Super easy install. Really dresses up the side of the bike. Fat plug wires just look much better to me than the stock little chintzy spark plug wires that come on there. And hopefully this video gave you some information on checking your spark plugs. I'm gonna venture to bet that there's a bunch of you that after you watch this video, you're gonna think to yourself, 10,000 miles, holy, I need to get out there and check my spark plugs. It literally takes 5 minutes. Go over it. If you pull your spark plugs out and you find your bike's running a little too rich or a little too lean, you're probably going to need to get a tune on the bike. Now that generally means that either you or maybe the previous owner has done something to the bike and hasn't tuned. And I mean like putting an open air cleaner on it, opening up the exhaust, anything like that that may need a tune done to the bike so it runs properly. If you find that your spark plugs are getting fouled out and you've got some issues in your tuning, and you're going to want to get that lined out. So this is just one other thing that we wanted to do to the Solo Cholo build that we're doing on the 15 Softail back here. Make sure to check out the rest of our videos on stuff that we've already done to the bike, and also check out the rest of the videos on the bagger stuff on there as well. If you have any questions on any of this, on this install, leave it in the comment section down below and I'll try to help you the best that I can. I'm going to get out of here and get back to work. I hope to see you in the next video, but until then, as always, be safe, keep your knees in the breeze. Thanks for checking out the video. Don't forget to hit that like and that subscribe popping up over here. And don't forget to check out the rest of the channel because we have a ton of bagger related and softail videos on our channel. And to get you started, maybe you can check out this one or this one. I'm not really going to say anything else. You can just click one of those and take you over to another video.